The world-famous Dracula's Castle is now up for sale. It's a legend that's taken on a life of its own, a story that's been the source of countless TV shows, movies, books, art, and the fears of little children and adults everywhere. The name that's inspired all these things is Dracula. The character from Bram Stoker's book really has become larger than life. You can't go a single Halloween without seeing at least a dozen people dressed up as this famous character. Well, for vampire fans, most will know that Dracula's castle is actually based on a real castle by the name of Bran Castle that was once inhabited by Vlad the Impaler. Some even say that Bram Stoker based the character Dracula on some of Vlad the Impaler's characteristics and personality traits. Well, the castle that's known around the world as Dracula's Castle is now up for sale. Here it is, the castle of the one and only Dracula. In real life, it was actually ruled by a man named Vlad the Impaler, who's famous for his connection to the name Dracula and the way he'd torture and kill his enemies. Known as Bran Castle officially, it's famous for being the castle that Dracula lived in from Bram Stoker's famous novel. The castle's currently on the market for a paltry $66 million. Chump change, right? There's even a rumor that the owners are willing to drop down to $13.4 million. Unfortunately, the place doesn't have indoor plumbing, which might be a real deal breaker for some, but not me. The castle's just under 800 years old, just about the time that most castles start to settle into their foundation, so you're getting a pretty good deal. It's in surprisingly good shape for how old it is. Since 2009, the castle's been under the ownership and care of members of the Royal Romanian Habsburg family. The family decided to open up the castle to tourists so everyone could enjoy this amazing piece of history. I love that this castle has battlements. I've always wanted a place with battlements so I can survey my enemies before we engage in battle. It might be a little on the small side for some people, however. The place only has 57 rooms. At least you'd get this awesome bed in one of them. I personally won't buy a castle unless it has at least 75 rooms, and even that's a little small. This place really does give off an authentic castle feeling with all the ancient stone, though. Even though there's electricity, there is no indoor plumbing. The family who owns the place is now getting older. They're looking for someone to buy the place so they can pass off the constant maintenance and renovation that comes with owning the castle. By far my favorite room of the house, I love old studies such as this. It most likely smells of rich mahogany. This looks like a place where an enemy of the castle would come to be judged. The sense of craftsmanship oozes from every corner of this place. Even the doorways are amazing. Look at it. You can almost get a sense of a modern style of design with some of the features of the house, like this massive fireplace. There's natural wood around every corner, however, which helps this castle keep its grounded and earthy feel. If you buy a castle and it doesn't have a long, dark stone passageway, then you got ripped off. I could be wrong, but those really look like fake cobwebs. You know, the ones you buy for Halloween? It does come complete with a medieval armory. Once again, if you buy a castle without one of these, I personally think you got the raw end of the deal. This place is absolutely remarkable. To think that this place could survive in this good a condition is really amazing. The upkeep and improvements of the place is a welcome addition as well. I'm sure no one would want to buy the place as it was before all the work that was done to it. So if anyone has an extra 66 mil lying around, you know what you got to do. Share Dracula's castle for sale with all your friends. Maybe one of them will buy it for you.